Welcome back to Stern Effects with me, Eran Stern. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to integrate text and video using Mocha Ae and few effects that will help you to improve your composition skills in After Effects. We are starting with this shot that I got from Adobe Stock of a motorcycle passing the camera on top of a desert road. I also prepared the title Desert Race ahead of time. So let's just pause it, select the video, and first we need to track it, which is going to be the easiest part. So I'll go to Effect, and under Boris FX Mocha, I'll use the built-in Mocha AE plugin. I'll launch Mocha by clicking on the Mocha icon, and because we have a lot of information here, I'll select the rectangle tool and then just marquee across the entire desert sand. And to see what I'm doing, actually what the tracker is going to yield, I'm also going to click on the surface plane and then stick those four corners to where I want or where I wish the title to be. This is going to help us judge the result as we are working on it. So I think something along those lines should work. I'll make sure to check the perspective for the track motion options, and I'll click on Analyze Forward. Now Mocha is going to do most of the heavy lifting for us. As you can see, it works pretty well, even when most of the surface or the tracking area is going to be outside the frame. It will struggle when all of the frame is going to be filled with dust and smoke. So I'm going to let it run until it's going to reach, I guess, this point more or less, when it's going to break. And now we are getting this stressful message that the tracking has terminated permanently. I'll click OK as well as OK over here. And I just want to find out where is the last good tracking point. Yes, this is it. So in my case, it is 4 seconds and 8 frames. I just need to memorize this. So I'm going to just name this one title. This is because I want to apply it to the title, then save the data that I've collected here and escape out of Mocha. Now I'll open up the tracking data and I'll click on Create Track Data. I'll choose title. Click OK, and now we can see that we have those points which are representative of the data that we've gathered. Now I'll select the layer in the timeline, press U, and then go to 408. This is the last good keyframe. And then I'm going to marquee around everything here and press Delete to remove those keyframes. And now I can go back to the beginning and apply the export to the layer in the timeline. Now, if I'm going to just select the desert race layer, this is a text layer, and click Apply Export, what will happen is that it's going to apply the export, but Mocha assumed that the layer is the same size as the comp, which is not in our case. So it looks kind of strange. Instead, what I'll do is undo the last operation and then select the text layer and then go under the layer menu, transform, and ask After Effects to fit this layer to the comp. And this is going to stretch it so it will touch the edges of the composition, but this is not enough. We need to pre-compose it. So again, let's go to the layer menu, choose pre-compose, name this composition title, and make sure to tick open new composition in my case, because I want to edit this composition as well as adjust the composition duration to the duration of the layer. All right, I'll click OK. I'll return back to the original composition. And because I want to add some texture to the title, I'll select the video layer, copy it to memory by pressing Command C, Control C on Windows, of course, return back to this composition and paste it over here. I don't need the Mocha AE effect for this instance, and I also want to freeze the first frame. I don't need the entire motion inside the title. So let's go to Layer, Time, and choose freeze frame. And this is going to apply the time remapping option with a hold keyframe, so nothing is moving here. The last thing that I'm going to do is click on this guy, which is the preserve transparency option. And this is going to look down the timeline and will use the alpha channel of any layers below, the combined alpha channel, by the way, to punch a hole over here. And this is the result. I'll close this composition. It doesn't look anything on this first frame, but if I'll move the current time indicator, we can see that it works. Now we can return to the Mocha plugin, making sure that we are still exporting the data to the desired layer, and then we can click Apply Export. And now we can see that it works. Now this is not going to be the end result. In fact, let's just check few blending modes to see what will work best here. So I'll hold down the Shift button and press the plus key to cycle between the different blending mode until I'll arrive to something that I think looks good. And in my case, it's going to be the linear dodge. So this is our winner. I'll press play or spacebar to preview the composition, just to show you what we have here. And of course, from 4 seconds and 8 frames, if I'll show you the keyframes, we don't have any motion. However, we still have keyframes. So we'll need to make sure that we are going to delete them, although we didn't have them in the Mocha plugin. So this is something that you need to do manually. In my case, I'll go a couple of frames before, so 406, and remove all the data. All right, so now let's fix it and have the title continue with the same motion, extrapolated motion, I should say, using a different effect. So instead of using the corner pin effect, I'll go to Effect, Distort, and apply the CC Power Pin effect, which has this very useful utility of expansion that I can keyframe, and it's going to expand the motion using the same perspective that we have for the effect. But to make it work, first we need to copy the keyframes from the corner pin effect to the CC power pin effect. So you can copy and paste those, or you can use expressions. I think expressions are easier and more flexible. So I'll open the CC power pin here in the timeline, and I'm going to use the link option to link the top left to the upper left, the top right to the upper right, and then the bottom left to the lower left, and finally the bottom right to the lower right. And now I need to switch off the visibility for the corner pin effect. Don't delete it because we are still referencing it, but we can close everything here in the timeline. And we can try to compensate by changing these expansion values. So I'm going to start by creating keyframes for everything over here. And then I'll go to the end of the timeline. And I will continue to move this in the same direction. So for the top, I'm going to go with negative 15. For the bottom, I'm just going to stretch it. And I have a little bit of experience with this because I tried it before I recorded the tutorial. This is why I know those values are probably going to work nicely, but you need to play with them. And notice that now, if I'm going to just press spacebar, it will more or less continue in the same direction. There is a little bit of a bump here, but it's going to be covered with all the smoke and dust in a moment, so it won't be noticeable. Now, I want to make the title a bit more bigger to cover more of the ground here. So I'll close the CC power pin and I'll go to the effect menu once again. Distort is our favorite category for today, and we are going to choose the transform effect. I'll place the transform effect before all the effects, and this is the secret. The transform is going to help you or allow you to change the title before applying the tracking data. I'm going to uncheck uniform scale and then play with the scale height and width. Let's start with the width. I want this title to be much more wide. Let's go with, 300, I guess, in this case. And then we can change also the height to 120, just to make it a bit more bigger and nicer. And you can see that all the tracking is still working quite nicely, including the compensation that we've created. Now, I'll return to the effect menu, go back to the distort category, and this time I'll apply the displacement map effect. I'll take the displacement map, make sure that it is above everything else, and take the displacement from the video itself and displace it from the ground pixels. So maybe 20 and 20 for both the luminance channels in the horizontal and vertical is going to yield the desired result. Something like this, I think, looks quite convincing. All right, let's twirl everything up and let's deal with the final part, which is to composite the smoke and the dust as well as the biker on top of the title. And to do it, I'll duplicate the video itself by pressing Command or Control D and place the video on top of the title. We don't need the Mocha Ae instance for this one. And let's start with the biker, isolate the biker. So I'll make sure I can see the biker more or less on top of the title. Go to the effect menu, this time to the keying category, and I'll apply the extract effect. What I need to do now is change the white point. So I'll grab the upper square here and start to move it to the left until I see most of the biker on top of the title. So 40 in my case is the desired value. And then I'll add some softness. And you can do it by taking the lower square and pushing it as much as you need. So something like this, I think, is going to work nicely. Maybe 25. Let's see. Yes, I think it looks quite nice. I'm going to return to the title and lower the displacement. I think the vertical displacement is just too high. Maybe also the horizontal. Don't want the text to bend too much. All right, now we want to bring the smoke on top of everything. So I'm actually going to duplicate this. This is going to be named biker. And I'll press Command D and duplicate another copy. Name this one dust. Reset the extract effect. And this time we want to go the other way. So we want to fiddle with the black point. So I'll start to move it until I see the smoke or the dust above the title. I'll stop over here at 135. And then as before, I need to add some softness. So I'll grab the lower rectangle and move it like so. Maybe a little bit less. Let's go with 50 and see how this works. I'm actually going to keyframe the black point. Let's go all the way towards the end and take this so the smoke is going to cover the entire scene. And then let's go to the beginning, press spacebar and preview the result. And the last thing that I want to do is color grade the entire comp, inspired, of course, by Mad Max Fury Road. So I'll make sure nothing is selected over here. Go to the layer menu, choose new, adjustment layer, and then go to effect, color correction, and apply the Lumetri color effect. I'll open up the creative section, and I happen to know that the first lookup table here, the scene space, is actually going to do most of the work for me. So I will apply it and then change the intensity to maybe 50%, or let's go with 70%. Go to the beginning and then maximize the composition frame by pressing on the tilde key and preview this composition. And this is it for this video. I hope these techniques will help you when you need to attach graphics to video and composite dust and smoke. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you again in the next one.